Hello, welcome to this channel Gain Java Knowledge, and today in this video we are going to develop a full stack application using Spring Boot and Angular. We will use Spring Boot for implementing a RESTful backend and will use Angular for creating front end. So first we will create Spring Boot application, and inside Spring Boot application we will just develop REST curl APIs. So here I have created one controller class, and inside controller class I will just develop four methods: get employee, create employee, update employee and delete employee. After that we will integrate these all APIs in our front end. So here I have created empty controller class, and here I have created employee service class. So here I will just auto void the employee service class and will import the class, and here I need to import this annotation, and here we need to define our model class. Inside our model class I have just defined these five properties. One is employee ID, employee name, employee department, employee salary and message. Now I will just generate setter getter for these properties. So I will just click, right click, generate setter and getter, and here I will select all properties, and here we can also generate the constructor. So here I will just click generate constructor. So we can select all the properties. Okay. And here we want to use zero parameter constructor, so we can do like this only. Just copy, paste and remove all the fields. So here we have generated zero parameter constructor and parameterized constructor. So if you want to generate two string methods, so we can directly go here and right click, generate, and here we can select two string method. So select OK. So here we can see two string method. Now we will go back to our controller class. So here first we will create the API to get all the employees. So here I will just define the API get mapping. And here I have defined the path slash employee. So here we will generate the method get employee in our service class. So here I am not connecting to any DB. So I will just use the list to store the data and will retrieve the data from list only. So here I will just define static list. And here we need to import this collector class. And here we also need to import stream, and here I will just return the list. So here it's asking for another parameter, because inside our constructor we have five parameters. Or we can just do like this. We can go to our employee, and from here we can just remove the message, because we are not going to use this message while creating employee object. So now I will go back to employee service class, and here we can see I have added four objects: 1, 2, 3, 4. Name 1, name 2, name 3, 1, 2, 3, 4. And from here we are just returning this list. So like now I will run this application and we'll test this API. So here we can see our application has started or not. So it's taking time. So here we can see our application has started at port number 800. 8080 soke localhost 8080 slash employee. So here we can see the response. We are getting all the employees. We can say our application is working fine. Like this, we can develop other REST endpoint, like to get employee by ID, update employee, and also delete employee. So okay, let's create one more endpoint, get employee by ID. So here I have just added the ID as a path variable. Okay, let's generate this endpoint. So I will just click on get employee by ID. So we need to create this method inside our service class. So here I have added this method. So here I will just paste this code here, and this code will return the list of employees. So from here we are just filtering the employee based on its ID. If you are able to find the employee based on its ID, then we are returning the employee. If we are not able to find, then we just are returning null. So here we can see we have developed two REST endpoint, one get all employee and second is get employee by ID. So like this we can add another endpoint like update employee, delete employee. Okay, let's add another endpoint to create employees, that is post mapping. So here we just need to generate add employee method, and inside request body we will pass employee, and we'll add another employee if you want to add. So this is the add employee function. So here I have added the code for this to add the employee inside list. So this is the list. So based on the list we will add in the end of list, and we are also returning the message employee added successfully. So like this we can add another endpoint to update the employee and also to delete the employee. So let me add first for update the employee. So here we are going to use post put mapping and employee, and inside path variable we are just passing the ID. So we need to generate this method update employee inside our service class. So we have created this. So we will just get the object from list based on our ID, and we'll update the value. So here we have added the code for this. First we will get the employee based on its ID, and if we will find, then we will get find first, and after that we will update the object based on the value that we are getting from our client. Then we will return the message employee updated successfully. In case if employee not found from this list that ID we are passing, then we will return employee not found. So like this we can add another endpoint to delete the employee. Here we have added get all employees, get employee by ID, create employee, and update employee. So we can also add delete employee. So here I have added one more endpoint to delete the employee, and here we are using @delete mapping, and now we just need to generate this method delete employee, and we will delete this employee from our list. So here I will just add the code to delete the employee from list. So this is the list. Here we have added all the employees, and from this list first we will get our first employee based on its ID. After that if it is available, then we will just remove the employee from, then we will just remove the object from our list. If it is deleted successfully, then we can return the message employee deleted successfully. If employee is not found from the list based on its ID, then we will just return the message employee not found. So here we have added all the REST endpoints, our all current API. So now I will just run this application and test our REST endpoint if it is working fine or not. So our application has started. So let me go to Postman. So here first I will call get all employees. So here we can see the list of employees. Inside our list we have added 4 employees. So here we can see in the response there is 4 employees. If you want to get employee based on its ID, so we will just pass the ID. and we'll send. So 5 is not available, so we are getting null. So if we will send 4, then we will get all details of employee: employee ID 4, employee name, employee department, employee salary. Like this we can perform update operation. So here we can see employee ID 4, name 4 and CSC. So let me update this record. So update employee by ID. So here I will just pass 4 and update name I am using here, and inside employee department I am just passing the value update department, and inside salary I am passing 2000. So let me send this request. So here we can see employee updated successfully. So let me get employee 4 based on its ID. So here we can see now we are getting updated name, updated department. Like this we can perform create operation. So here we can see we are just getting 4 employees. If you are calling get all employees API, so in the response we are getting 4 employees, 1 2 3 4. So let me add another employee. So here I have added new, and department is new department, and salary is 999. So let me send this request. So here we can see employee added successfully. So let me call and we'll check. So now here we can see 1 2 3 4. Here we can see 5 objects are available in the list. So like this you can perform the delete operation. So let me delete third one. So here we are getting response employee deleted successfully. So let me go and check get all employees API. So we have deleted 3. So here we can see 1 is available, 2 is available, but 3 is not present here. After that 4 and 5. So here 4 objects are left. So like this we can perform current operation. So as we have created our Spring Boot application, and our Spring Boot application is now up and running. So we can check if I will hit this endpoint, we are getting all the employees. So we can say our Spring Boot application is up and running. So now we can now create a simple Angular application that is capable of consuming the REST controller API. So here we will use Angular CLI, that is a powerful command line utility, to create our Angular application. And Angular CLI is an extremely valuable tool since it allows us to create an entire Angular project from scratch, generating components, services, classes and interfaces with just a few commands. Okay, let me go to one folder. So here I will just type cmd. So once we have installed npm node package manager, we will open a command line console and type the command. So if we want to install command line, then we just need to type this command npm install hyphen g @angular/cli. So I have already installed, so I do not install it again. And if you want to provide any specific version, so then we can define @ and we can define the version, otherwise it will install latest version. So now I will just type the command to generate the Angular basic project. So here I will just type ng new front end application. So this command will generate the Angular project and entire application structure within the frontend app directory. So here I have selected CSS, click enter again. So here we can see our app has generated with basic directory structure. So let me go back to the folder. So this is a frontend app folder. So let me copy this path and go to Visual Studio and we'll open this project. So click on file, open folder. So here I will just paste the path and select folder. So if we look inside the frontend app folder, we will see that Angular CLI has effectively created an entire project for us. And Angular's application file use TypeScript, a typed superset. A type superset of JavaScript that compiles to plain JavaScript. So let me run this application. So here I will go. So here I will just type the command ng serve. So if you want to define any specific port, so we can type here, otherwise it will default run on 4200. So this command is not available when running the Angular CLI, so we need to go inside this folder, cd frontend app. So ng serve. So node packages may not be installed, try installing with npm install. So I will just type. So here if I will just type command ng serve. So it's not able to find the path, so I have just set the path. Now I will just type the command npm install. So now it's installing the node modules inside our front end app directory. It will take some time to install and load all the packages, so we can wait. So here our all packages are installed. So now we will go back and we can start our application from here, ng serve. So here we can just type y. And here if I will go to my project back, so here we can see there is the entry point for this project is index.html file. So I will open this and here I will just replace the content of this file. So here I have added bootstrap import and here I have imported bootstrap version 4. So we can give our application UI components a more fancy look. And here I have imported bootstrap import JS. So here we can check now our application has started and its default port is 4200. So let me run and open in browser. So here we can see our front end app is running. So now we will go back to our code and inside our HTML file. And this is our TS file. So let me search for this front. So here we can see we have defined front end app. So in the our browser if you will go, so we can see front end app is running. So here I will change the title. So now I will save it and go back and refresh it. So here we can see front end app created and app is running. So if I will change the message here, it will also affect on the browser. But here it's showing some error So for this we need to install one another package of npm. So let me copy and paste this error message here. The syntax required tslib, so I will go down and copy the command from here. See, we just need to run this command npm install tslib. So I will go back here and stop the application. So here it's showing the error. This syntax require an imported helper, but module tslib cannot be found. So once this command will execute and install the library, after that we can check the error again. But our application is working fine, so we can see here. So here we can see the app root tag inside the body section, and they look rather weird, and app root is not a standard HTML file element. The app root is the root selector that Angular uses for rendering the application's root component. So we can see here this app root is available inside here. Selector is app root, so it's rendering this file. So our app root is bind with this tag only, with app component.ts file. So if we are doing any change here, it's also affecting at UI level. So here we can see OOO is also present here, so it is binded. So here we can see the most relevant part is the @ component, and @ component metadata marker or decorator. So it contains our selector. The selector is the HTML selector used to bind the component to the HTML template file, and another is template URL, the HTML template file associated with this component. So this is the app.component HTML file associated with this. So here we can see app.component.html, and style URLs we are binding app.component.css, and we can bind one or more CSS files associated with this component. So we can use comma separated values. So as we have defined here, we are using app.component.html and app.component.css with this component, and we have bind it. And the selector element, that is app root, we have already defined inside our index.html file. So here we have defined this selector app root. So let me open app.component.html. So just remove all the content from this file. So save it again. So if I will go back to browser, so here we can see it's also showing empty, because there is no HTML content available. So let me type something here, h1 new content. So if I will go back to browser, so here we can see new content, and here I will just paste this content. But we need to create one more component, and inside our component we will write the code. So we will create component for our employee. So here I have added one router link, and the path for this router link is /employee. So let me go to browser, and here we can see employees. So if I will click on employees, it will redirect to this path that we have defined here, /employee. So let me generate one more component. So let me go to this frontend app folder, and here I will go inside source folder, app folder, and here I will just open cmd. And here I will just type the command ng generate component employee. So here we can see employee.component.html file created, and it also created employee component dot spec dot ts, employee component dot ts, employee component dot css, and it's also created one file that is app dot module dot ts. So here we can also see the entry of app employee component inside our app dot module dot ts. So let me go to our code. So here I will open app dot module dot ts. So here we can see app component is present here and employee component is also present that we have created now. And if I will go here, so here we can see employee folder is present here now, and this is the code. So if I will go here in app.module.ts, so we can see employee component is present here and it's empty for now. So let me go to now app component.html file. So here we have defined the router link is slash employee. So let me go to app routing file and we will define the path here. So inside routes we can define the path. So let me enter here, and here I have just pasted it. So this is the employee component that we have created. So I will just import, and here I have defined the path for this employee component is employee. And if I will go to employee component.html file, so here we can see employee works. So let me go to browser. If I will click here, it will open employee works. So we are able to see here it's working fine. So let me go back to code. So as we know, if we want to fetch our REST API, then we need to call our API from our frontend app. So let me create the model that very properties we want to fetch from our backend API. So here I will generate one class, employee class, and inside employee class I will define all the properties that we are getting from this API response, like employee ID, employee name, employee department, employee salary. So let me go back, and here I will generate one more class. So here I will go inside source app. So here let me open cmd. So here I will just type ng generate class employee. So Angular CI will generate an empty employee class. So here we can see employee.ts is generated. So let me populate it with few fields. So I will go back here, and here we can see employee.ts is generated and it's empty class. And here I have added four properties, but it's showing some error. So we need to use constructor and need to initialize these properties. So let me initialize these all properties here. So here I have defined value and initialize all these properties inside of employee class. And if required, we can also generate setter getter for these all properties. So here I have just generated setter getter. Set ID, get ID, set name, get name. So now our employee class is ready. So here we can see our client side domain employee class already set. So we can now implement a service class that performs get and post requests to our endpoints. And our service class will allow us to encapsulate and access to the REST controller in a single class, which we can reuse throughout our entire application. Okay, let me open the console. So here we will create our service class. So here I will just type ng generate service employee. So let me enter. So here we can see employee.service.ts file has been generated. So let me go to code. So here we can see employee.service.ts is generated and it's empty class. So to consume our HTTP, we need to use HTTP client. So here inside constructor, I will just pass it HTTP client. So here it's showing some error, not showing any option to import this. So let me go to app.module.ts. I think we need to add some module. So here I will just add the modules that is required for this application. So here I have added HTTP client module. So let me import this, and meta dialog I think is not required, so we can remove. So form module. So here we have added HTTP client module and form module. So let me go back to employee-service.ts, and here we can see quick fix is available now. So here I will just click and import the HTTP client. It's showing this compile time error. It's showing some TS library cannot be found. So it is not affect our project. So here I have just re-imported this project again. Now it's not showing any compile time error. So let me add the code to consume our RESTful API inside our employee service class, and that we will use inside our entire project. And this is the base URL of our app. So here I have defined localhost 8080/employee. So we can check it from here. /employee is the base path for all API. Employee, update employee by ID, get employee by ID, delete employee. So this is the base URL up to /employee. And this is the function that we can use to call get API. And here we need to import quick fix, add import from RxJS, employee model that we have already created. So this is a function get all employees. So we can use this function if we want to retrieve all employees from our backend REST API. Like this, we can also use another function that is create employee, get employee by ID. So here we just need to pass the ID, and inside URL we will just pass the ID. So it will get employee based on its ID, and this function we can use to create employee, means for post call. So this is the post call that we are using while creating employee, and this is the update employee function, and here we are just calling put API, and this is a delete employee function. Inside delete employee we are calling HTTP delete method. So based on its ID, it will delete. So these are the functions that we will use to consume our RESTful backend API. So now here we will go to browser, and here on browser we can see employee works. So let me go to this HTML file, employee component.html file, and here I will just remove this line and will add this content here. So here what we are doing, we are just adding one button. So this button we can use to, when we will click on create an employee, it will open the pop-up. So we will able to add the detail for employee, and we can save the employee. And this is a table that we are using while retrieving the data from API, and will show here in the table. And now we need to define this function open model delete employee inside our employee component.ts file. So here I will go employee component.ts file. So here we can see employee component, there is no function. So let me paste these functions here. So here we can see it's showing some error. So we need to import employee. So now I will go here. So we need to import employee service class. So we also need to import router meta dialog. We are not using meta dialog, so we can remove it here. So here we can see inside our employee component I have added ngUnit function, and this function is calling employee service get employees. So once this class will load, it will automatically call get employees API, and it will load all the employees and show in the table. and it will store inside this dot employees variable, and this dot employees variable we are using here inside our HTML file. So here if I will go, we are iterating employees, and from employee object we are getting employee ID, employee name, employee department, employee salary, and this is the open model function. So based on this open model function we will decide we are creating new employee or we are updating the employee. And like this we have created some more functions like update employee, delete employee. So delete employee, here we are just sending one alert. If you want to delete this employee, surely then you can click OK. So it will delete this employee from our list. And this is the load table data. So here we are just calling get all employees API and it will load all the employees. So after deleting we are calling this function. So once we have deleted one employee from our list, after that we are again calling the same API and loading the data into table. So load table data, and after updating the employee we are again calling the same API, so it will show the updated data in our UI table. And this is the API that we are using while creating employee. So once the employee is created, again we are calling same API get all employees API and we load the data in table. So now let me go to browser. So here we can see inside our list we have already 4 employees. So we are able to see these 4 employees here. Let me try to add one more employee. So here we can see here only 4 employees are available. So create new employee. So test employee, department is test department, and we can add salary here. Just click on save. So once we will click on save, it will save into our list and will also update here. So here we can see 5th employee, test department, 999. So if you want to edit the salary for this employee, for now it's showing 999. So if you want to update it and make it 10,000, so we will just click update. So now we will go down, scroll down, and here we can see salary is also updated. And if you want to delete, so we can just delete this employee. So like if I want to delete name 4, so here we can see now 4 is deleted. So like this we can perform all the current operation for employee. Okay, thanks for watching this video.